How do you do, senor, I'm sure?
Just a little business with Mr. Fogg. If you don't mind, senora.
What? Yes, of course. I will just pop on down to me pies then.
Signor Pirelli.
Oh, call me Danny. Daniel, I beg you tonight when it's not professional. I'd like me 5 quid back, if in your don't mind.
Why?
That's me boy, talking.
It'll hold me over till your customers start coming in. And then it's half your wages every week on Friday, share and share alike. Do we have a deal, Benjamin Barker?
Why do you call me that?
Well, at least you've got a nice full head of hair on you.
Well, to tell you the truth, Mom, it gets off a lot.
You don't remember me. Why should you? I was just a down and out tall original lass that you hired on for a couple of weeks to see my parents such likes. But I remember these. And you, Benjamin Barker, later transported to Botany Bay for life. So do we have a deal? Or do I run down the street to my good old pal, the Beetle Bamford? You would think I was mad.
Thank you.
fourth time, sir, you have been brought before this bench. And though it is my earnest wish to temper justice with mercy, your persistent dedication to a life of crime is such an abomination before God and man that I have no alternative than to sentence you to hang by the neck until you are dead. Court adjourned.
Crowning jewel on such an amazing day.
It is a happy day for me too. Walk home, for I am used to you. In order to shield her from the evils of this world, I have decided to marry Joanna next Monday.
Ah, sir. Happy news indeed.
Strange, though, when I offered myself to her, she showed a certain reluctance. That's normal enough in a young girl. Now that she's had time for reflection, I'm sure she'll greet my proposal with a more sensible.
I need another noise.
What? myself to Spain.
These premises are hardly prepossessing, yet the beaver tells me that you are the most accomplished barber in all of the city.
That is gracious of him, sir. And you must excuse the humility of my establishment. It is only a few days ago that I began business. Sit, sir, if you would, sir, sit.
Now, this one's empty, so you just sit here like a nice quiet boy, huh? See how nice and cozy it is? And I'll go get another bottle from the larder.
And what may I do for you today, sir? A stylish trimming of the head? A soothing skin massage?
You see, sir, a man infatuate with love, her ardent and eager slave. So fetch the pomade and palmer stone and lend me a more seductive tone. A sprinkling, perhaps a fresh cologne, but first, sir, I think a shave.
I ever gave. answer, catching fire from one man to the next.
'Tis true, so love can still inspire the blood to pound the heart we pile with more.
What more can man require?
Love, sir.
More than love, sir.
What, sir?
Women.
Ah, yes, one.
Pretty women.
No, I'll never hug my girl.
there. Come on, come on! Sweeney's waiting. I want you, Cletus. You, sir. Anybody, gentlemen, now don't be shy. Not one man, no, nor 10 men, nor 100 can assuage me.
I will have you.
And I can get it back even as he gloats in the meantime, a practice on this honorable throat. And my Lucy lies in ashes, and I'll never see my girl again. But the work waits. I'm alive at last, and I'm full of joy.
Well, that's all very well. But what are we going to do about him? Hey, listen to me. Do you hear me? Can you hear me? Get control of yourself. What are we going to do about him? And there's the boy. I left him asleep in the parlor, but we better go have a look, make sure he's still there, so come on. No problem there. He's still sleeping. Baby lamb, that one. Later I can pop him off with some story, easy, but him? What are we gonna do about him?
Later on, after it's dark, we'll find some secret place and bury him.
Well, I suppose we could do that. Don't suppose he has any relatives gonna come looking around for him, but, well, you know me. Bright ideas just pop into me head, and I keep thinking. Seems a downright
shame.
Seems an awful waste. Such a nice plump frame, or what's his name has. And, nor it can't be traced. Business needs a lift. Debts to be erased. Think of it as the rift, as a gift, if you get my drift. No? Seems an awful waste. I mean, with the price of meat, what it is, when you get it, if you get it. Good, you got it. Take for instance, Mrs. Mooney and a pie shop. Business never better, using only pussycat and toast. Now a pussy's good for maybe 6 or 7 at the most. And I'm sure they can't compare as far as taste.
Mrs. Thomas, what a charming notion.
Where
and
it goes,
and yet, oh, great. As always, Mrs. Thomas, how I did
it's
without your
obvious.
It's an
idea. Think I've got it. Let them go.
Also,
I'm deep.
How choice. How rare. Of what's the sound of the world out there?
What, Mr. Todd? What, Mr. Todd? What is that sound?
Those crunching noises pervading.